So I know it's been a while since I've been on here. I just came back. You know, my life's been pretty crazy. I graduated college. I moved into a new apartment with my boyfriend. And then I was diagnosed with general anxiety disorder and depression. So for a while, I was just kind of dealing with that and trying to figure out how to move on from that, how to deal with that new aspect of my life. Throughout the whole time, I was watching ASMR videos, you know, enjoying them, helped me a lot. And I've learned a lot of new things along the way that I'm excited to show you guys. So just letting you guys know that there's a lot of new content coming up soon. And I just wanted to give you a little video, you know, as a my thanks for staying subscribed and being with me, or being patient. I mean, you might have also just forgotten me, because I mean, I would have forgotten me. So yeah, today I'm going to read you a quick tarot. I'm still learning it. I've got it about like 2 weeks ago, and I'm still trying to find my own way of doing it. And before I do tarot, I like to clear the room energy, especially since as of throughout the day, you can have different emotions and different energies come around the room or around the house that you bring from outside. You know, some days are better than others for me, so I would like to get rid of the bad energies from other days so I can welcome in positive, you know, thoughts and positive energies for the next few days or just for upcoming. So I have, it's sage with lavender, and it smells very nice, it's very soothing. The lavender scent isn't as strong as you think it would be, which is very strange, but I also have dried lavender, like the actual purple flower as well. I'm very picky. I like to make sure my smudge sticks actually catch fire, because sometimes they're not as cooperative. Oh, and you'll be joining my cat Athena. She's here with us today. She decided to follow me, and she normally does. Put some around her too, because she's very perceptive of these things. Right? She likes this one. Had her for almost 2 years. We'll have her for 2 years in November. But she'll be 2 years old in April. We had her, we got her 7 months. So, she's a pain in my butt. She's so intrigued. Yeah. Have sage, and that just kind of, I like to think of sage as the powerful herb that forces all the negative energies out. It just kind of says, get out. Get out, if you know what I mean. So, I like to, on my person, you know, put it around until I feel like I've taken in quite a bit. I like to probably light it one more time. For a little bit more. This has lasted me a bit too. So, just to be sure. I find it very therapeutic looking at the different smoke formations. I like to think I control them sometimes. Just move it around, swirl. I start off with the sage. slash lavender. Then I go to, I would normally do sweet grass, but I don't have any more right now. I gotta go get more. We'll put this down. It's gonna keep smoking, though. I should probably put it out. Sorry. Oof, it's all going up my nose. Okay. Alright. And the next thing that I'd like to do after using sage would be Palo Santo. This one's actually from the country that I'm from, Peru. So it's like a holy wood that you burn, and it kind of helps finish the cleansing process. Well, usually you do sage, sweetgrass, and then Palo Santo, but in this case, it's all I got, and it's not too bad. This takes a while to catch fire. It's very finicky. Let's see. I find the smudging process very therapeutic overall. I feel overwhelmed at times from whatever's going on in my life. And then I'll just light some of these up and just take a minute to breathe. Something that we so often forget to do in a day. Because who has the time? You have bills, you have school and work and everything else. So I like to do this. Here we go. I wonder if you saw that. This is a very strong smell. It can be a bit overwhelming for some people. I'm told it reminds them of the smell of a church. Which, yeah, makes sense. It's holy wood. If you're not distracted by her. Okay. All right. Now that is done, we can move on. So, I have a couple crystals with me to do the tarot reading. I'll first show you the tarot cards. This is my tarot deck that I have. It's called Work Your Light. Oracle cards by Rebecca Campbell and the artwork by Danielle Noel. So it's kind of how it looks. And I'm going to show you more once I get started, but it's a very nice box. Inside it says, "You are the Oracle." Very pretty. And it comes with a booklet of all the different cards and their meanings. And on the back it just tells you the different type of cards, the different categories of cards that are there. So, but yes, as far as the crystals that I have, a lot of times when I do it, I like to work for my problem areas, which is anxiety, depression, how to combat those. So I brought a couple, very minimal amount of my actual collection of crystals here. So first one that I'm going to bring. I have four here. Okay. The first one is one of my favorite stones overall, and it's called citrine. And mine looks like this. Now, citrine for me is the energy stone. It has just a lot of energy in its color, yellow in my, you know, the sun, very bright, very warm, energizing. And that's kind of what citrine does. It's also the manifestation stone. So a lot of the times when I'm anxious or I feel like, you know, everything's gonna go wrong, everything's wrong, I feel wrong, all that stuff, I usually like to hold on to this one like that and just remind myself that I can manifest anything, you know, that I put my mind to in my life, because you attract, you know, you get what you attract, I believe. You attract what you put out. That's what I think what it is. So this one helps me, makes me feel brighter overall, helps me with the solar plexus area. So I like this. And I have multiple citrines. This is one of the few I have that are like my favorites. Oh, well, you can see also I have citrine right there. Citrine along with some rose quartz pieces that I have. And rose quartz is a very gentle, loving stone that just promotes self-love in the most comforting way. It's the best way I like to put it. I also have citrine. Sorry, it's too loud. And the necklace is over here, so I like citrine a lot. Next two stones are the same type of stone. They have different formations. So this is clear quartz, and I like to have clear quartz along with anything that I set my intentions to, because clear quartz is like the stone of all stones. It has the highest vibrations, and it's used to amplify the energies of other crystals. So if I want to put manifestation with my citrine, you know, I like to have clear quartz with me to help amplify that. And I like pieces like this, where it has little, like, I think tower pieces here. They stick out. It's all jagged. Athena likes it a lot, as you can see. This one has a big point right there. Like, it's pretty big. You can actually hold it like that from the point. So, I like clear quartz a lot. There's just something about it that seems fake fantasy. So I like to have that along with tarot. And my other clear quartz is big, but it's more of a singular big piece. So looks like that. Yeah. It's like two pieces if you can see it like that. Has the point right there. And it slopes down. It's quite heavy and is flat on this side, so it can lay like that. And I like this piece very much. I got it a couple months ago. I'll say about a month or two ago, actually, not even a couple. Just being generous. But yeah, so I like to have a lot more clear quartz, just totally amplify what I'm trying to put out there. You gotta send a really strong message sometimes. Yeah. So that's my other clear quartz. My last piece is definitely smaller, and this one helps me in particular, and it's lapis lazuli, or lazuli, however you pronounce it. This is my piece. It's relatively small compared to what I've shown the rest of, but just love the gold flecks that appear in the deep blue, how royal and rich it is. It's very beautiful. And lapis, it's a stone of inspiration. Excuse me. It enhances, your wisdom and your truth overall, and it helps you with having a brain fart. It helps block negative energies as well as helps your self-awareness. So this one really is good with getting rid of also your emotional baggage, which, don't we all have that? So that's my lapis. Think she does. Let's do the reading. Someone's excited. All right. Stall any longer. Here's the booklet. It has the same artwork on it. It just has all the different meanings of the cards so we can get a better idea as to what we're dealing with. So that's how it is. It's very pretty, and I like the sound it makes. It's like that hollow. These are the cards. They look like this on the back. Very pretty. And then see artwork. Here's, let's see. There's this one. Artistry. It's very beautiful, something that I'm very attracted to. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to shuffle these cards, and with an intention in mind, I'll pick out the top card after I feel like something in me tells me to stop shuffling. It's all about intuition based, really. Just like the rose petals. Right. So we're going to shuffle. Now don't come for me and my shuffling. I'm very bad. So I have to do it slow. Maybe a couple more times. Two more times. Feels right. We're gonna pick the topmost card. We're gonna read it. And whoever, see how it relates to you and your situation. I don't see tarot as all foreseeing prophecy. It helps bring perspective into multiple ways that you can change future things or things that are currently happening in your present. So that's how I view tarot, as more of a tool to help. So in that way, with an open mind, let's start. The card that you picked. The ever unfolding rose cracked open. It's happening for you, not to you. So, we're going to look into the booklet. And we're going to read it. And eventually, I will get good enough to not read the booklet. Ever unfolding rose, cracked open. It's happening for you, not to you. The challenge of life is to keep your heart open when you most want to close it, to let life crack you open, to open through hurt and loss, to allow what is falling away to fall away. Being human is a courageous act. A life well lived is full of losses and tragedies as much as triumphs and adventures. Wherever you find yourself at the moment, life is coaxing you to keep your heart open, no matter how much it hurts, to continually unfold, to let life crack you open. Perhaps you're going through a difficult time right now. Instead of cursing the difficulty, see it as a blessing. To open yourself up to the truth that, perhaps as hard as it may be, life is happening for you, not to you. And one day, in the not too distant future, you might just bless the thing that broke you down and cracked you open because the world needs you open. Now is the time to go gently, to treat yourself like a tender, sweet baby, to unwrap yourself in a blanket and trust that the mother has you cradled in her arms. The seas may not all be smooth sailing, but you're safe and you are held. One day, not too far from today, you will look back at the transformation and be blown away by the poetry of life. Everything is going to be okay. I don't know about you, but that was very helpful for my current situation. I hope whoever there heard it, needed to hear it, it helped you. Anyway, thank you for joining me, and I will be posting more from now on. This is just a little intimate thing I wanted to do with you guys as a thank you for anyone who is even interested in watching me after these many years. And I look forward to seeing you guys as I post more. And I love you guys. And have a great day, night, or whatever, wherever you live in the world. Bye. Bye, Athena. Hey. Say bye. She's awake, but she's not.